Hey there! How is the 2021 treating you? Well, it's just been a week, and as I said in my previous video, the change of a calendar year is exciting to me because I spruce up my desk, I have new stationery laid out. But it's also exciting to me because I look back and replan my existing goals, and that's exactly what I was doing this year. I'm looking back at the lessons that I've learned from the previous year. And I'm sure you did that too. Well, 2020 was not such a bad year to me personally. Yes, I did lose a very close family member. My aunt passed away this year. And I've also heard a lot of bad news coming in from across my network of connections, whether it's family, friends, close friends, acquaintances, and of course in the news, there's a lot of passing away of people, but that's one end of the spectrum. The other end was that I spent quality time with my family the most in my married life so far. I've seen my husband the maximum so far, and also spent really meaningful discussions and quality family time together. So that is the other end of spectrum. At one end, I had gone through a very bad patch in my health. And at the other end, I also was able to recover from it quickly and course correct wherever I was going wrong. And all this happened in 2020. And of course, the highlight of it all for the last year was that I spent much of my time, as I think you did, in a state of gratitude. We are suddenly awakened to the fact that we are blessed and that we have so much of love and abundance in our lives. Incredible, isn't it? But there are seven lessons that I have learned from 2020, and I'm going to share that with you in this particular video. So let's begin. Number one, routine is important because it lets us make time for everything. Follow a routine, but ensure that you have enough variety that you don't get bored with it. And I've experienced that with my workouts. Number two, accept and adapt to whatever comes your way, because you cannot control much of it. There's no point in fighting what you cannot control, right? Number three, be prepared. Have a plan B, C, D, or any of the other alphabets, because that is the only thing that will get you out of any situation. Number four, live in the now, because this is reality. I may have my head up in the clouds, I may have a lot of dreams, but if I want to seize today, then here is where my mind should be. Number five, be content with what you have, because you're already blessed much more than you can think of. You can always be ambitious for the future and be content with the present at the same time. Number six, slow down. I think this was the best lesson of it all. Life is crazy in a fast lane. And if you're like me, you get a high every time you succeed in it. But life is beautiful in the slow lane, and we have experienced it in 2020, right? And the only person to manage in here is you, no one else. Number seven, keep learning. Unlearn and learn again, because life will continue to teach you. The new year will continue to teach you different lessons. Only if you open your heart and mind will you end up being wise. So there, those are the seven lessons that I've learned from 2020, and I'm grateful for these reminders. In the words of Paulo Coelho, life is too short to wake up with regrets. So love the people who treat you right. Forget about those who don't. Believe everything happens for a reason. If you get a chance, take it. If it changes your life, let it. Nobody said life would be easy. They just promised it would most likely be worth it. So what has 2020 taught you? Do let me know in the comment section below, or you may reach out to me in any of the social media platforms that I'm in. Well, that's it from me. Thank you so much for watching. If you like this video, you know what to do. Hit the like button and share it with your friends, and I'll see you next week. Until then, take good care of yourself. Bye.